coming out still.
Tyler, on that note, we obviously, with COVID happening, all the CDL events got canceled. And I'm just curious, now that you're not coaching anymore and you don't really have any affiliation with the league besides the fact that you might be an analyst here and there.
Yeah.
How do you think that Activision is handling the Call of Duty World League and the new franchise? I mean, let me ask you this even better. If you were in a position with an organization, hypothetically, where you're an owner, would you have bought into the league?
I don't know if I have enough information to answer that well in terms of like how the money goes into it.
Mm-hmm.
My immediate thought would be probably not. I just don't see, we don't have enough details on like what those deals are looking like, I feel like, because if you're just looking at the numbers of paying with the players, like what they're making, like rumors of those numbers, some of those are pretty absurd. I just don't really see how you get a return unless there's some sort of, Activision hooking it up in some way, shape, or form. I know you decided to opt out into buying into the league, and your reasons why made a lot of sense to me personally. I don't know. For me, it probably would depend on like the roster that I could get, because I feel like there's only a certain amount of players, a certain amount of brands within the league that warrant what they're actually getting, if that makes sense. So like, if you're getting like I don't want to say bottom of the barrel roster, if you're getting a shitty roster, then I don't see how it would really make sense financially. As far as like how the league is going too, viewership has been, I don't want to say going up, but it's been pretty solid. I think the switch over to YouTube was a bit of a shock for the viewership so far. And then the game doesn't help either. Modern Warfare Competitive is kind of a mess. I don't feel like the players are getting like the necessary support. The maps aren't great. There's a lot of things on the competitive side that just don't really help out. I feel like maybe, I don't know, if the league debuted on like a Black Ops 4 or potentially the next title, all this, our view on the league might be a lot different. But I feel like the way that it's been going down here, I don't think competitive has really gotten an update in months and months and months. The spawns are a mess. The pros are constantly complaining. The balancing isn't great. There's just so many things wrong with it. And like, I love COD. I love competitive COD. It's where we grew up, right? And I want it to succeed. But I feel like there's just so many things holding it back, and it's largely due to the game. And it starts with that, because if the game's good, if the players are supporting it and all in, like, everything's going to look better. The gameplay is going to be more fun to watch. Viewership's going to be going up. There's going to be more people playing competitive, and it all kind of stems from there. So I feel like the game being in such a poor state for competitive is sort of like the root of like the problems right now. Do you guys agree or disagree?
Listen, there's always something, man. That's the way it's always been. And I think a good testament to it is when you talk about nerfs. Like, I think this is probably the longest the meta has ever stayed the same in a game ever, right? Like, typically there's a shift as the year goes on, but we've just been like, it's basically what, three or four SMGs and one AR on a team. And by SMGs, I mean just the MP5. Like, there's just no room for anything there. And